All right, let's talk about the physical connections on the back of the console. The first place to start is actually with the two power supplies. And these are redundant, which means you only need one to operate. Highly recommend the second one being on a UPS or an uninterruptible power supply. So if you do have a power fault, it will continue working. These are also hot swappable if needed. Above that, you have a plate, and this is where you would actually add our OptiCore option. This can feature either ST connectors, Neutrik optical con connectors, or HMA connectors. And this is to connect via our racks and other consoles in your system through OptiCore. To the right of that, you have your GPI and GPO over TRS connectors. These can be for simple things like foot switch, and you know, you can advance through your snapshots, tap tempo through that, contact closure for other things you may need, such as system control, power sequencing, and things like that. You also have your MIDI in and out, and through, so we can connect our MIDI on this console to, once again, fire program changes on other external devices or vice versa. Below that, we have our stealth processing with waves, and this is the wave sound grid port. This will go from this port out to the sound grid server for external processing of the hundreds of plugins that Waves has available that we will run on the desk and control from there. On to the right, you have your digital AES inputs. So these are two AES ports. That would be two channels per port, four channels total. Then you have your eight XLR inputs. Those are mic line analog inputs. Below that, you have your AES outputs and your eight line level outputs over XLR. The bottom right hand corner, you'll see your network port and your two USB ports. The USB ports are there for Waves licenses, for saving, storing sessions, moving those between consoles if needed, or the offline software. The network port here is a basic network port, so we can take the port on this console, connect it to a wireless access point if we want to remote control the console via our iPad app, or connect it to a wired network maybe for offline control via our offline software. Then you have your VGA port, and the VGA port is for your overview screen. This will be as simple as you would hope, plug in the screen and get to see everything from all of your inputs, all of your outputs, all input metering and output metering from there. There's a few other things you can add to it as well. These are your keyboard and mouse connections, resetting the console if needed, fault indicators, and then two Cat5 ports. And those two Cat5 ports are what we call DMADI ports, and they're basically a MADI over Cat5. So each port is individually 64 by 64 channels up to that, and it will actually connect directly to one of our racks. So one Cat5 cable can go from the console to the rack and carry up to 64 channels each direction. That's at 48K. We have racks available. The D rack would have 32 in by 16 out. The D2 rack would have 48 in by 32 out. Those are all individually connectable, or they can be adapted to talk to any of the racks that we currently build. We also have BNC MADI connections. So this is a more traditional implementation of MADI, where we have a separate coax BNC cable for the input and the output. Each one is 64 channels in or 64 channels out. That's at 48K. Anything on the console can be assigned to any of these ports as needed. And then finally, you have your word clock input and output. This can take word clock from any source or take what's generated in the console and send it out to any other source as needed.